Attorney Calea, you were saying something about you would like to respond to what I said before we took a break regarding the vice president, if that indeed ends up being President Duterte himself after the 2022 elections, end up calling the shots or ends up calling the shots. Okay.
I think the framers of our constitution, Christian, did not envision that a president would go down to the level of putting himself so low to run for vice president just for personal gain, no? Kumbaga, yung scenario na yan, hindi naisip. Plus, I guess, hindi rin natin naisip na yung scenario na yung anak o kaya yung photobomber na naging senador, eh ngayon gusto magpresidente, siyempre, kung sabihin lang niya na mag-resign ka o bumaba ka dyan, and then, of course, then that would open up a way for succession of the president. That's why, as I said, that that scenario is not far-flung in the same way that the scenario of a president going down to a vice president is not far-flung, given the capacity of this administration to disregard the constitution and the rule of the land.
And perhaps this is only consistent with this interesting description of President Duterte as a disruptive president. That could swing both ways, right? For better or for worse.
For better or for worse, yeah. Well, but whatever you would like to describe him, which, but as I said, no, do you like 6 more years of failed pandemic response? Do you like, siya na rin na nagsabi, Christian, 3 to 6 months, tatapusin niya ang drug war. Hindi naman niya natapos. Siya na rin na nagsabi, 6 months, tatapusin niya ang corruption. Hindi naman niya natapos. Siya na rin na nagsabi, 3 to 6 days, tatapusin niya ang rice cartel, ang endo. Hindi rin niya nagawa. Siya na rin naman na nagsabi, pagdating sa West Philippine Sea, inutil siya. Eh gusto ba natin ang another 6 years na presidente na inutil sa West Philippine Sea? So I guess, okay. That's why, as I said, I think the Filipino people, the Filipino voter will reject this type of presidency for 2022.
But remember, it's not President Duterte running for president anymore in 2022. One option is Sara Duterte herself. So,
which is
she may not necessarily be bound by the false or unfulfilled promises of her own father.
Well, I don't think kumbaga ano lang yan na Christian, kung mangga, mangga pa rin, kung apple, apple pa rin, di ba? Hindi naman pwedeng from an apple tree you will have an orange. So it is the same same tree, same fruit, and you would see naman the reactions of Mayor Sara. Did she contradict the EJK? Did she contradict or fight for West Philippine Sea? Did she contradict na nung hindi pinatuloy yung endo nung tatay niya? So did she contradict the loans that the president has done? So it's still a continuation. Hindi naman niya kinontra anything that the father did. It is actually a mirror of what the father has done from Davao City onwards.
Okay. Also, this earlier I was asking about this consolidation of forces from a national level, because again, it's different if you talk about the presidential election. In this case, don't you think even members of the administration coalition might be turned off by this brazen attempt to float a possible Duterte tandem? Because a vice presidential run might in itself be brazen already for some people. But if you talk about a daughter and father tandem, that is even more brazen. And don't you think that could end up turning off members of the administration coalition?
Christian, turning them off is a very light word. Actually, I'm not at liberty to tell their names, but let me just assure you that starting October, once the certificate of candidacies have been filed, you will see a lot of local chief executives and a lot of people in government until election day jumping the fence. And as I said, no, isa-isa yan, lilipat din yan. And they will see that indeed the tide or the bandwagon will go on the side of the alternative or isang bayan or the opposition. And they would see that this ploy of the government is only, it's nothing but a ploy to perpetuate a family in power.
Okay. Again, we still cannot get in touch with Attorney Raul Lambino, but we have on the line Congressman Joey Salceda. Good evening, sir, and thank you for joining us on the program. Our apologies for the very short notice, but we appreciate your participation in this conversation. Congressman Joey, you may unmute now. Good evening, sir.
Yes. Bakit ka naman ang gigising?
Because of the very interesting developments over the past several days. In particular, the statement that you made that no doubt, according to you, Sara Duterte is going to run for president and it's possible that she might be running unopposed. What is the basis of this very bold prediction of yours?
Howard knows me. He knows my political instincts. We're both from the same province. We may differ in principles, but I think in terms of political assessment, we just look at the numbers. Me, I'm based it on the numbers. Empirically, if you look at the surveys, the trending, we look at the top six. Six are from the administration. And then, of course, Lenny. And the only formidable opposition is really just Lenny. And I think, well, based on their own statements and our statements, she may, what I said is she may be insignificantly unopposed.
Okay, pero no doubt, sabi niyo, that she will run for president.
Oh, there's no doubt. If I can show you all my chats.
With whom?
With Sara.
Did she categorically say that she's going to run for president?
Well, sabi ko paano to, maraming gusto mag-interview sa akin. Because I was apologetic that again the issue was open, I said that I want the cheese running, and sabi niya okay lang yung kung ikaw na muna.
Ubra pa ba itong ganitong style, Congressman Salceda, yung pakipot
playing
politics
coy?
Pakipot yung playing coy, pero in reality that's pakipot strategy, di ba? We saw this already in 2016. It worked.
Ano pa?
Hindi, gagana pa ba itong strategy na ito? Yung medyo pakipot? Ginagawa ito ng ilang politiko, di ba? This work for President Duterte.
Well,
sabi siguro natatakbo siya, pero bakit ang papakipot pa?
I think it's already the betting season, you know. By May next year, you will be voting. And you will be voting for people who will file on October. And therefore, the vetting season already starts because you only have 4 months before October. So you cannot choose people who did not file unless you can do again another substitution like the father, like President Duterte. So I think may problema tayo sa sounds.
What?
I don't know.
I can hear you.
Beneath the movements are there. You can see political rearrangements already emerging, although they're not being announced. Alliances are being formed to support their candidacy.
Okay. When does she intend to make this announcement? Would it be actual October filing of COCs or she might...
Tanungin ko. Kasi kanina tinanong ko eh. Kasi pumunta nga si Gibo at saka si doon kay Sara eh. So, sabi ko, ano to? Ito na ba to? Sabi niya, well, not just like what she answers, no comment. Sabi ko, hindi ako media, wag mo ako bigyan ng no comment.
Okay. Ano yung ano? What do you make of that photo that was shared by Congressman
Andaya?
Sinasabi niya na done deal. Pero ang nasa picture sa likod, ang nasa likod niya sa picture was Gibo Teodoro. So mukhang Sara Duterte Gibo Teodoro, is that true?
I'm not sure. I'm not privy to all the other things. I think just looking at her persona and matching it with the political landscape, I think if you track the vaccination, the vaccine per day is already above the level that's needed in order to per day in order to reach herd immunity in the sa target date, and very much well ahead of the election day itself. Number two, the contract with Pfizer is the single largest Pfizer contract outside the U.S.
So what does this have to do with the preparations for 2020?
Well, that tells you why I feel comfortable with their candidacy. If it's just the general macro environment, when the general disenchantment is really about the handling of the pandemic.
Okay.
So I think there will be... when I said Sara would run, the market jumped from 6.2 to 6.8, and you can look at the charts.
Okay. Pero may question, Congressman Salceda. I'll say this in Filipino because this is how people who saw that possibility described it. Hindi masyadong garapal. If you are going to field your own daughter to run for president in the next election cycle, that's one. Garapal na raw yun, di ba? And number two, worse, kung si Duterte mismo tatabo for vice president.
Yung Duterte, answer ko agad yung Duterte. Yung Duterte, I don't think the president will accept the resolution. It is the usual thing, you know, the same resolutions were made for Ramos to continue running the ship through Pirma, even for Gloria, and you know, there are these things very, well, unique to Filipino politics, well, no matter how long.
But they Sara Duterte presidential run.
Pero sinasabi mo na ano, bakit lagi siyang 26%? 60% of Mindanao. Saan ka kukuha ng pangtapat sa 60% ng Mindanao? Tapos kung tatakbo yan, I'm sure that some of the other people who depend on the Mindanao vote. And based on the political arrangements or the alliances, she would already have two of the biggest, and she has five.
Kanina, when before you joined, Attorney Calha and I were talking about this possibility. So sabi nyo, you would circle the wagons when you talk about the Duterte-Duterte tandem. Oh, sige, let's talk about the a possible Sara Duterte presidential.
What circle the wagons? I did not say that. I don't see the possibility of a Duterte-Duterte.
But I thought you made use of that idiomatic expression. Anyway, I must have misheard you. Anyway, you don't see that possibility. Sige, pero yung Sara Duterte presidential run, in itself, hindi ba masyadong ano yun?
Anong garapang tao ang pumili?
Ha?
How brazen is he was not nominated? She's being nominated by the survey, you mean?
You have so many choices supposedly given the population of the Philippines, but after
the survey shows that at the end of the day, the people's choice is sovereign, and the current preferences all consistently over several surveys, the lowest she gets is 26.
So ultimately, it's the choice of the people.
Precisely. So I think at this point, with only 4 months before July, before October, I think she and all the names that are being posted, let's say the top six, Lenny is probably the only formidable opposition there.
Okay. I think it was political science professor Julio Tehanki who made use of this term before, whenever people would say that ultimately it's the choice of the people in the ballot. But here, according to him, you're basically talking about procedural democracy, meaning democracy reduced to procedures. But before that actual ballot is cast, you saw a lot of politicians, in this case, perhaps President Duterte, already consolidating power, resources, et cetera, to make sure that he would be perpetuated in power. How would you respond to that?
You are dun sa party, President, I cannot speak about it. But dun sa part ni Sara, you have to tell me which one of those activities can be attributed to her.
The fact there that are she is the daughter forces, of the president.
In the main political groupings that are now, of course, convinced that she should run, and they are supporting her.
Okay. We're nearing the tail end of our program for tonight. Again, I'd like Attorney Howard to respond to that to those statements by the Congressman Salceda. So basically, mukhang formidable candidate lang from the opposition is Lenny. But given the numbers, mukhang ano siya, magiging sure victory for Sara Duterte.
Hindi naman po sa tingin ko ganon. Number one, salamat Christian at good evening Kong Joey. Idol ko yan. So sabi nga niya kasama kami sa probinsya. But if you look at this at it this way, no, there's nothing going for Sara except the Duterte brand. If you look at capability, if you look at track record, I would vote Congressman Joey anytime for president or vice president. Mas magaling yan talaga kay Sara. But sadly, mas sikat si Sara dahil anak siya nung presidente. That is the only thing going for her. I understand trust that we look at the same numbers. Kung Joey already said that. But I think what numbers we have now is only a snapshot of what is today, but not what we will have come May 2022. It's still a long way ahead. And as I said, it is an uphill battle for us. But trust you, me, Christian, and Kong Joey, we will unite the opposition. We will unite the democratic forces. It might be an impossible dream, but I am sure that once united, we will come up with the numbers come May 2022. Which is what counts, you know? The numbers today does not count. What will count will be the numbers come election day in May 2022. And whatever it is that there, I mean, hindi ko naman sinasabing may nagawa o walang nagawa. Sa akin, that is another issue for the candidates to say or to explain during their campaign.
Okay, final response from Congressman Salceda. Okay, last word from you.
I don't know. You always say that you cannot assign the sins of the father if as defined by Howard to their sons. But I wouldn't use that argument. Number one, when she was RDC chair, she doubled the regional GDP from 3.4 to from 3.7 to 7.4. Number two, when I was working with her as RDC chair, we sit together as a co-president in Luzon RDC. I could see her quite differently. She has a complete staff work. You know, every time before she says something, there's a folder being brought to her. And I could see that she would have a more expansive access to what you can call unlike the father who surrounded himself with all the ex-generals. This time around it would be a different thing because the way I saw her. Okay. When DLTF CAC was announced, she said, "Why give this money to Davao? Anybody can get what's given to Davao." Okay. So you can see judicious use of resources. I can name you so many things that differentiate.
Well, basically, she has her own accomplishments. But unfortunately, thank you guys for joining us this evening. We have to end this interview already because it's way past our time for this particular time slot. But thank you very much, Congressman Joey Salceda, for joining us. Thank you very much, Attorney Howard Calleja. And again, unfortunately, Attorney Raul Lambino was not able to join us.